confess, I feel fine.
Sure, Blake, I know. It's nothing like a few scratches and a possible concussion to bring out the best in us.
Well, I don't even have a headache.
Try telling that to the X-ray machine you just met.
Now, where are you taking me?
To your room.
My room? I am not staying here.
But you are. At least until I can complete my tests. Don't worry, you'll be out of here in the morning, first thing.
Just a minute. Now, wait a minute.
Krystle, did he or did he not insist on being taken here to Memorial so that he could receive the best possible care, namely mine?
That's right, Les. He did.
So that, I imagine, settles that.
Dr. Davy, call the operator. Dr. Davy, call the operator.
You've heard about Blake already?
What happened to him?
Do you really care, Alexis?
Yes, of course I care. I was married to him. He is the father of my children. You going to tell me what happened?
What happened wouldn't have happened if you hadn't arranged that wedding circus on our lawn and driven us out of town.
Nurse Staunch, to pediatric.
And most important, I want you to see to it that this man does not, now I repeat, does not try to escape.
I'll have guards posted at the door, Dr. Osgood, round the clock.
Blake, watch out for Miss Kent here. She's one tough broad.
One tough person, Doctor.
That's what I meant. See you later, Blake. Goodbye for now, pretty lady.
Bye, Miss. Doctor, I'd like to have a word with you, please.
Pretty lady.
Oh, thank God. Thank God.
Come on.
I might have lost you last night. I didn't know if you were hurt or even alive.
Alive? Well, I'm very, very much alive. And after that, I'm sure you'll agree that I should get out of this place and that we should go home where the two of us can be alone.
Oh, no, you're staying right here. In the meantime, I'll phone the house and let everybody know you're here and that you're all right and nothing to worry about.
Why don't you use this phone? Huh?
I had it disconnected. I know you, darling. You'd want to talk to the office and half the household, including your grandson. Especially your grandson.
Krystle. I love you.
I love you too, Blake. So much. Some horseman spent half the night in the mud. No wonder Nick Toscani couldn't find you.
Toscani, what are you talking about?
He told me he went up the mountain to find you yesterday.
Well, he found me. We talked.
He told me he didn't see you.
Why would he tell you that? Now, what the hell is he up to?